We have such advanced imaging now. We have these high field MRI scans, and we have intraoperative scanners. This happens to be a CT scanner, but of the same quality that used to occupy an entire room, now they occupy, they're literally like something you push around like a, you know, a floor sweeper. We don't need to use microelectrode recording because we have accurate imaging. We have the method to see where the target is, and using the technology we have available today, we can direct our electrodes precisely to the target without sticking sharp things into the brain. We use a navigation system. This system has a series of infrared cameras that look down on the head and allow us to guide our electrodes precisely to the targets within tenths of millimeters. We do all the planning for the electrode before the patient even comes in the room. Sometimes the day before, we'll plan out the electrode trajectories. That's what this is happening here. So this is all the setup before the patient comes into the room. For the patient's in their holding area right now with the family. They come in and they go to sleep. The last thing the patient remembers in the room is, okay, we're going to go to sleep now. And the next thing they remember is, you're in recovery, it's over. That's what they remember. And I don't know how many of you have had general anesthesia before. It's like that. Nothing happened. So this is what we do. We put the head, neurosurgeons love to have the head very stable. So we have a special head holder here. And you'll see us now we'll prepare the head. And we'll place these little tiny metal screws in the head just as indicators of position. This allows us to now fuse the image we have with the surgical space, which is the brain. So we need these little screws to do that. And then we tell our optical system, which is up here, where each one of those are within a tenth of a millimeter. And then we scan the patient. And now we can unify the images and the surgical space, which is the patient's head. So that's the reason we put those screws in. So we'll go ahead and do a scan before we start. That registers everything into one common set of images. Here's the images coming out. And then those images are immediately transferred to our workstation here where we actually do the planning and the registration. So this is what we're doing now. We're telling the system where each one of those points are located because we've made a plan, but we need a hole to place the electrode through. We've got a plan in the brain to avoid anything that's dangerous, but we need a hole to come out from. So we actually have to back calculate where the hole is, that's where that point is there. We sterilely drape off that CAT scanner, and then we'll proceed with what is basically a surgical procedure at that point. We'll open the skin, we will make the holes, we will mount a plastic system you'll see on the head that allows us to guide those electrodes precisely to the target. That's what this is. And And then it's just a matter of, I hate to say video game, but we're watching a target on a screen and we're basically pointing the electrode, here it is right here, precisely at this 1 millimeter circle right in the middle of that big circle. That's basically the video game part. Once we've got that done, we advance the electrode, pull it back through the system, and do the other side. It takes about, from the point of putting this on to finishing that procedure, takes about 15 minutes. And we do the other side in about 5 to 10 minutes. So the whole thing, the whole procedure from skin incision to completion, closure, is about 1.5 to 2 hours. So that's what we're doing right here. So we mount two of those systems on right and left. We place both electrodes at the same time and then leave the electrodes in place. Now, the one further thing you'll see that we do is that we before we leave the operating room, but before we even take any of this off the head, we will check the CAT scan. That is, we know where each electrode contact is before we leave the room. One, we know there's no hemorrhage, which we've never seen a hemorrhage, but we know there's no hemorrhage. And second, we know we're precisely on target within a few tenths of a millimeter. So that will happen, you'll see in the video, that will happen next, once we've implanted both sides. Excuse me. So now we're doing that follow-up. This is our final scan, patient's still asleep. We haven't left the room, and if we need to make any correction in the electrode, we will. And we do, and that's probably about 10 or 15% of the time we'll make a minor correction in where the electrode location is. We have to redirect it into the target area. So patient's asleep still, do another scan before we take any of this apparatus off, And if we have to move electrodes, we will, but usually we don't. And then, and as I say, we know that there's been no other complication. So at that point, we take all that plastic apparatus off, close up the skin, take the patient out of that head holder, the patient wakes up, and by the time they really wake up, they're in recovery. So this is now checking the CAT scan, showing that we're precisely on target. And I'll show you, I think I've got some pictures of those images. So this is what it looks like at the end. We have these two U-shaped incisions, and we take out those metal screws, which are out already, and the patient returns to recovery with a bonnet on. So they'll take out the endotracheal tube. So here we go. The electrodes we can see here and here are precisely where we wanted them. These electrodes are only about a millimeter big, so we're right on target.